My name is Shane Fan, and today I'm going to be showing you how to measure alignment angles on a Class 8 truck. The first thing you're going to want to do is go around the vehicle and check your tread on your tires, just stretch it, also check the pressure, because if you have bad tires, you're going to have to change that, and that can also throw off your alignment angles. You also want to check your air pressure, make sure that it's at the right PSI. That can also throw off your alignment angles. Get it squared away. We've already done it, but I'm going to show you how to do it. Pretty much you just square it off with the frame. You measure both sides from the frame to the tip of the bar. And make sure both sides measure the same length. And ensure that it's centered. The first thing we're going to measure is the tram. To do that, you get the height of the tire and you will cut that in half. We've already done that. Mark the area in the center of the tire. To measure the tram, you use the bar. Measure from there to the bead. And you will do that on both sides to get the tram. Tram tells you the alignment of the wheels in reference to the frame of the vehicle itself. The next thing we're going to measure is the offset. We're going to use this bar to reflect this. To measure the axle offset, all you have to do is put the tape measure to the frame and measure it to the end. And you're going to compare that to the other side, and that's how you get your offset. And the offset is just how far the axle is sticking out from one side compared to the other. So that might have to be centered as well. The next thing we're going to measure is our thrust angle. We're going to do that with this rope. What we're going to do is secure this knot onto a bolt. We're going to wrap this around the tire. We're going to make sure that it sits to the bead. We're going to go to the front in a bit. But pretty much we're going to start our measurement as soon as this part touches this part, as soon as that happens. We're going to make our measurement right in the center of the tire on the bead. Measure our camber, caster, and here's how you do it. With the protractor, just set it on the fork, zero it out. And place the protractor on the flat surface of the vehicle. And that's how you get your camber measurement. To get our caster measurement, we're going to put our protractor on the frame itself.
And we're going to zero that out as well.
And then next, you would put your protractor. First, you'd have to take the grease fitting cap on the kingpin off. And then you place the protractor on top of that kingpin. And that's how you get your caster reading. Alright, next we're going to measure our toe. In order to do that, I have an assistant on the other side. And pretty much we have on both tires, we have chalk drawn into the center of the tire. We're going to use a tape measure to measure the distance between the other the chalked out line and this chalked out line. And then after that, in order to get your toe in or toe out, you would do the same to the rear of the tire, just like the front. The front is the front measurement is more than the rear, then you know that you have a toe out. If you have the front measurement that's less than the rear, then you know that it's a toe in. That's pretty much it. Thank you for watching.